can all your clothes be dirty? You gotta take more responsibility for yourself when you move out. You can't wander around wearing no trousers all your life.
Responsibility, yippee. Next stop, a dull job, followed by a dull wedding with dull kids. You'll be old and dull before you know it, just like these two.
No, I won't. When I move into the halfway house, I live by my own rules.
At Cam's place, we have to vote on rules, rotas, everything. Democracy, she calls it.
Having a say in your life is positive. It reaches into our inner selves.
You'll be giving this lot the vote next.
Why not?
Yeah. Why not? Elaine, you are a genius.
Well, I wouldn't say that exactly.
Such vision. I can just see the bestseller now. Elaine, Democracy and the Inner Self.
Bestseller?
Better get started now before someone steals the idea.
Now what? Only ask for some trousers.
So, voting gives you all kinds of grown-up responsibilities. What do you think?
Brilliant, Elaine. Can we vote on anything?
Absolutely. Anything you want. Just propose it.
Okay. I propose there are no rules. Vote.
No, I don't think that,
That's that, then. Passed unanimously.
Yes! Well, no, hang on. Wait.
That woman. That girl. This place. Why are you wearing a suit? An interview. Why on earth would you want another job?
More money, less work.
As if I haven't got enough problems.
Oh, one other thing. Could you give me a written reference?
Hi, Duke. Where are you off to? Getting married?
Married? Who on earth wants to marry him?
I'd marry you, Duke.
Hey, what are you two up to?
Hello. I'd like a temp cook for a week, please. What about a day? Half a day? An hour? Hello? Hello? So, how's the brilliant idea coming along?
Marvellous. Everything's, you know.
Great. Well, you can make the lunches then.
Oh, I'd like to, but the thing is I have to observe. Take notes. Can't Duke do it?
No. He's been headhunted.
Oh. So Mr. Smart really does listen to my suggestions after all.
You recommended him for another job.
Oh, brilliant, isn't it?
So, if there's no rules, when do we eat?
When we say so.
Well, we could if there was anything to eat.
Someone's nicked the lot.
Who do that?
Boys, of course.
Oh, typical. They're all the same.
Yeah, greedy and selfish.
Hey, that's sexist. You girls have got a serious attitude problem.
Oh,
I'll give them attitude.
Do you think they run this place?
Girls. Typical.
I suppose we could share with them. No!
Yeah, right. Good on you. Let's get cooking.
Looks like we're just in time. Make mine 2 eggs sunny side up.
Yeah, in your dreams.
But we're hungry.
Okay, here you go. Enjoy.
Hang on, there has to be a solution.
Yeah, we'll fight you for it.
Okay, game on.
Okay, leave them alone, come on.
We could web this bench anytime.
Oh, I said let's go.
Yeah, go on, run off.
Yeah, you bunch of girls.
Bunch of girls with Tracy Beaker.
It seems quiet after the care home.
This is where the real care work is done. You can make a real positive difference here.
It might take some time getting used to working in an office again.
You mean one like this? This would be your office, pot plant and all. As far as I'm concerned, the job's yours. All I need is a written reference. You do have one, don't you? A reference like that before.
Oh well. Nice to have met you.
Sounds like he thinks the world of you. You must make quite a team.
I guess so.
When can you start? Have you got your national insurance forms?
Sorry. No, I'll post them on.
No, I want to fast track this. I'll pick them up in the morning. So, welcome aboard, eh?
Yeah, I mean, what are they gonna do?
Yeah, exactly. We'll stuff ourselves, then veg out with telly and computers.
Oh no.
She wouldn't.
They haven't.
Looking for one of these boys?
Give us that!
Wait, I think you need to discuss this. Hello? Anyone?
How's the meal, boys?
Give them back!
We'll fight you for him.
And you can forget about the vegging out as well.
You can't do this.
You can only get one channel without the remote. Wildlife.
And don't even bother trying to use the toilets.
Discipline holding up then.
Pretty much, and it'll be terrific research for my bestseller. Don't worry, I've got everything under control.
Good luck.
This is better talking. You have to admit it got a bit silly. Not very grown up, is it?
No. Grown-ups would have had strikes.
Riots.
Wars.
Right, well, anyway, it's a time to negotiate. How about a compromise?
Good idea.
Yeah.
You can have half the food. If you cook all the meals.
How about you bog off?
This is war, Beaker.
That suits us. So what do you suggest? We just give in?
No way! We should attack!
When the time is right.
How's things?
Fine. Suppose you think when you go away, everything just falls to pieces.
No, I just thought that...
Yeah, the fridge is empty. Everyone's starving and the kids have turned into packs of wild animals. But apart from that, everything's perfectly normal.
No, Crash! No! But I'm so hungry! You're hungry. I'm so empty. I could eat a horse.
I'll take these and get off.
Meet the kids first.
I'd love to, but, busy.
You must be able to find some common ground. A like you share. But a dislike, then. Surely something in here makes you go mad.
Now you come to mention it.
Yeah, there is.
Great, so why don't you resolve your differences and unite?
Sounds good to me.
Okay, I'm up for that.
Great. So come on then. Let it all hang out.
Okay, if you say so.
Already.
Just typing up my notes. It's all going brilliant-ish. Smart, quick, save yourself. Get out of here!
Duke, let's get out of this dump. They're animals.
Actually, they're not animals. The kids who need care. That's why it's called a care home. But you've forgotten that with your comfy office and your pot plants. Goodbye. Who needs an office when you've got all this?
Remember, viewers, watching TV gives you square eyes.
Not! You've done Goldilocks, you've seen Cinderella, but there's no one quite like Bika.
Hurry up, Shant. It's feeding time.
He's not here.
What?
He's not in his box. Of
course he is. You're just not looking properly.
He's not me.
He's not in his box.
What's the matter? What is it?
He's gone! Oh, no.
What kind of monster gets up your nose?
A bogeyman. Oh, Sid.
What's the difference between an elephant and a biscuit? Have you ever tried dipping an elephant into a cup of tea?
Red alert, red alert. We have a sense of humor failure. I repeat, we have a sense of humor failure. This'll make you laugh. Bounce. Do your Dot Cotton impression.
You're such a pretty girl, Sonia.
Okay. Dot Cotton being attacked by piranha fish.
Sonia! Fire!
Oh, it.
This is really hilarious, okay? Bounce. Do you explode in Alien?
Yeah. Later, boys. There's something wrong with him.
Yeah. Doesn't he realise we're like the funniest people here?
Huh? Comedy Dream Team. That's us.
If we can't make him laugh, no one can.
He was like my best mate. I could tell him anything.
Call yourself a Wellard. Wellards don't cry over nothing.
But...
Nothing. Got it?
Me and Roxy are family. We're the only mates you need.
Now, let's split up and search.
Hi, my name's Bouncer Pacova, and when I grow up, I want to be a pop star.
I just can't get you out of my head, boy, your loving is all I think about.
Have you two been drinking that fizzy drink again with all the additives?
No, we're just trying to make you laugh.
You know, like this.
I laugh as much as anyone else.
What? You never find anything funny.
That's not true. I have a finely honed appreciation of comic irony.
Yeah? Okay. So when was the last time I had a good, proper giggle then?
La la la. La 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 la.
Has anyone seen Marco?
Sorry.
We were supposed to be making an animal hospital.
Oh dear. Tell me the truth. Am I a humourless grump? No, come on, this is serious. Tell me.
You've had a very heavy workload recently.
What's that, code for you've got no sense of humour?
Well, everyone has. Yeah.
That's ridiculous. I like a laugh as much as the next man.
Oh.
Gotcha.
It's the only plastic joke.
That is childish and silly, and it's totally unfunny. Isn't it, Duke? What's wrong with you?
Are you looking for Marco too?
Real snakes got out.
Cool. Snake?
His name's Rex.
Go on, Rio, go and look in the hole. Go on, I heard a noise.
What kind of snake is he?
Dunno, a slithery one. Lives near water. Get a grip, or I'm not helping. Got it?
I just couldn't bear it if anything happened to him.
Perfect. This can't fail.
Thank you, dearie. Oh, I'm sure my bum looks big in this. Oh, massive, Dippy, massive. The size of a large asteroid. Enough of your cheek, Edna. Now go and ring the bell before your tights fall down. Off you go, little girl. We have an urgent appointment with the manager of this magnificent establishment. You know, but it doesn't laugh much. If ever. Everyone off again. Oh, get you with your handbag.
Bro, not that hard.
Good afternoon, sir. We're here to foster a couple of children. Two? Nice, polite kitties. Mm-hmm. No smelly ones. We don't want any riffraff.
You're rehearsing a play. I see what you're doing. What are you doing?
Sid, you really do have a problem.
Have you seen Marco?
Sorry.
Crash, you know about snakes, don't you?
Snakes? Yeah, I know about snakes. Every type, every mutation, every variety. I wouldn't risk being caught face to face with one, though. And not know whether it's a suffocator or a venom spitter.
Are you scared of them?
No way. Snakes are cool.
Okay, which snakes live near water?
Boa constrictors. They eat anything from a mouse to a live antelope.
That's what Rio's got then.
You're joking.
No, we find it before it gets really hungry. I'll get Jackie to help.
Constrictor on the loose in the dumping ground. You gotta do something right now.
Yeah, nice try, Crash. You nearly had me laughing. Maybe if you'd said there's a 6-foot celery snorting yeti on the rampage, I might have giggled. But a snake, a bit predictable, really. Sorry.
I'm not joking, Sid. There's a very large, very hungry boa constrictor somewhere in this very care home.
Ooh.
Health and safety won't allow it. So what are you gonna do about it?
Forget it, Crash. It does not get more funny the more you labour it. Hang on. On a scale of 1 to 10, how funny would you say this is? What did one earwig say to the other earwig as they fell out the tree?
I don't know what.
Earwig O, earwig O, earwig O. That's not funny.
Can you see anything?
No. There.
It's only a vacuum cleaner.
Of course, I knew that.
Crash's snake joke.
No, Sid, there really is a snake. Really, really.
Ooh, and I'm Posh Beckham's grandmother.
Rio, she's been keeping it a secret under Chantal's bed.
No, he's gone.
We can't find Marco anywhere, but we found Rio's snake.
Oh, yes!
I'm afraid it's bad news.
Oh!
By the look of things, he's been that way a long time. We put him in Crash's snooker cue box.
His need is greater.
Sid? Sorry, it's just that the long box.
It's Rio's pet in there.
Not funny.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Maybe we could bury him in the garden.
Out now.
Of course we could bury him in the garden if that's what you want, Rio.
I'd like to see him for one last time.
I wouldn't, Rio. There's not much left of him.
Don't worry, Rio. Let it all out. I don't mind.
He's alive. It's his skin. You fickles. He just shed his skin. Rex lives.
That's great.
Where is he then?
And where's Marco? No one's seen him all morning.
No.
Where have you been?
In the attic, making the animal hospital. Annabelle can be our first patient.
He's mine. His name's Rex, and he's not sick.
But I found him.
He's a wild snake. All right, Crash?
Yeah, sure. Just a harmless little wild snake. It's harmless. It's totally harmless. I just got it.
Chicken!
He's a wild creature, Rio. He'll get sick if you keep him in a box.
I'm not
giving him up. You can't make me.
Come back in. It'll be tea time soon.
Rex won't eat anything.
Maybe he isn't happy.
I think you should let him go, Rio.
Come on, buddy. He's got to hang out with his snake mates.
Goodbye, Rex. I'll never forget you, my scaly little friend.
If you like.
Of course, I'm all right. What sort of wimp do you think I am?
Where's Marco?
Marco! Supper's ready!
I was just checking on my stick insects were gone. I set them free, because you said it was cruel to keep animals in a box.
Think I'll skip supper tonight?
Yeah, me too.
I'll have yours then.